Dear students, in our day-to-day life, we observe various moving cars, bikes, rickshaw, etc. We can observe all these circular wheels rotate about a moving axis. It is a combination of the translation motion and rotation motion. We call it rolling motion. So, here now we are going to learn the concept of rolling motion. For learning the concept, let us take a rolling wheel here. You can observe this wheel is having radius r and it is moving with the velocity v and rotating about axis passing through the center with the angular velocity omega. Now let us take point ABCD on the circumference of the ring and let us find the velocities of these four points. We know this is the combination of translation and rotation motion. That is a superposition of, we can say it is a superposition of the translation and rotation. So, we can make translation and rotation separately. Like this, translation motion and this is the rotation motion. Here the object is rotating about this axis. And this we can call this as a pure translation motion and this as a pure rotation motion. We know in pure translation motion, each and every point on the body move with the same velocity as center of mass. So, here we can write V, V, V and V as velocity of these point which is equal to velocity of the center of mass. And in case of the pure rotation, we know in pure rotation, we consider axis as fixed and object rotating about that fixed axis. So, here we can observe the radius of rotation is r. So, tangential velocity here is omega multiplied by r. Here is also omega multiplied by r, omega multiplied by r and omega multiplied by r. So, now let us make the superposition. You know, superposition is nothing but it is a vector summation. So, here we need to do the vector summation of the velocities due to translation and rotation. So, let us make this diagram again and let us make single wheel and mark the velocities due to translation and rotation. This is velocities due to translation and let us make velocities due to rotation. Omega r, omega r and here omega r and omega r. And topmost point now. You can observe here. These two vectors are acting in the same direction. So, the summation of these velocity vector will be equal to V plus omega r. And here you can observe these two vectors are at 90 degree angle. So, here we can add V square plus omega square r square. Let us write this first V plus omega r. And this is under root V square plus omega square r square. And here at the bottom most point, velocity due to translation is V and velocity due to rotation is omega r. And we don't know the magnitude of V and omega. We don't know which one is greater, V is greater or whether omega r is greater. Let us assume V is greater than omega r. So, the velocity at this point will be in the rightward direction. That is the difference of V minus omega r. And now, velocity at point D is not different from the velocity at point B. So, let us make vector summation here also. This is the velocity at point D and it is equal to under root V square plus omega square r square. Now, if we focus at point C, we can say for different value of V and omega, point C will move with the different speeds and maybe in different direction, maybe in the forward or backward direction. And for the suitable value of V and omega, if V is equal to omega r, if we substitute V is equal to omega r, that means Vc equal to 0. It means the relative velocity between point C and surface of the contact will be 0. And this type of the special rolling motion is called the pure rolling. And here you can observe Vc equal to 0, that means V equal to omega r. And V is nothing but velocity of the center of mass. So, here we can write velocity of the center of mass equal to V equal to omega r. Then you can say here, point C does not slide on the surface. On other word, we can say body is said to rolling without sliding on the horizontal surface. That is, body is rolling on the horizontal fixed surface without sliding. And this is called the pure rolling. Correct? Now, let us calculate the velocity of points A, B, C, D if ring is having the pure rolling condition. We can write here, in case of the pure rolling, VCM equal to V equal to omega r. And velocity at the bottommost point will be 0, as we discussed. And velocity at the topmost point equal to V plus omega r is again equal to V. So, it is 2V. And velocity at this point, that is V, VB, it is again equal to V. So, it is root 2V. And here also we can say it is root 2V. We can observe here, in case of the pure rolling, velocity at the bottommost point, that is the point of the contact with the surface, equal to 0. Velocity of the center of mass equal to V. And velocity of the topmost point equal to double the velocity of the center of mass. If it is moving with the velocity V, the topmost point of this ring will move in the same direction with velocity 2V. In rigid body rotation, each point moves in a circular path relative to any other point on the rigid body. It means we can say each and every point of the ring is rotating about point C with the angular velocity omega, or we can say ring is rotating about point of contact of ring with the ground. So, here we can say this ring is rotating about this point. And if we consider the rotation motion of point A with respect to this point P, which is on the ground, so radius of rotation of this point is equal to 2r, and angular velocity is omega. That means the velocity of the topmost point in tangential direction will be equal to omega multiplied by 2r, because radius of rotation is 2r. So this is equal to 2 multiplied by omega r, and omega r equal to V. So, we can write here directly this velocity as V A equal to omega 2R equal to 2V. Correct? Now, we can observe in superposition method, we also got the same magnitude the velocity. Now, let us consider point B. Here you can observe the radius of rotation is root 2R, because this is R and this is also R. So, this radius of rotation is root 2r. So, velocity will be tangential to this direction, that is perpendicular to this direction. That means velocity of point B equal to omega multiplied by root 2r, and omega r equal to V. So, this velocity is root 2v. And we can observe this velocity also is having the same magnitude which we have calculated using the superposition. And this point D is nothing different from point B. So, here we can say the radius of rotation is again root 2r, and velocity will be in this direction, and this velocity is again root 2v. Now, we can say if an object is rolling without sliding on a fixed surface, we can consider each and every point of the object is having pure rotation about point of contact. Let us clarify this point of the pure rolling through one example. Let us take this sphere of radius r, and it is having velocity v and angular velocity omega. And this is the point of contact of this sphere with the ground. And we know in case of the pure rolling, velocity of this point should be equal to 0. And we know the property of the rigid body. What? In case of the rigid body, each and every point on the rigid body have the circular motion with respect to any other point on the rigid body. So, if we consider the rotation about point P, if we consider point P and we observe the velocity of other point on the rigid body, we can say all the point will rotate about point P with the same angular velocity omega and in the same sense. And here we can say the body is rotating about point P, and P is not moving. That means if it is the pure rotation about point P. If it is the pure rotation about point P, we can observe here the radius of rotation here is R. So this velocity should be perpendicular to the radius. Let us make the circular sense of rotation of this point, and we can observe this is moving in the tangential direction. And if we take one more point near to point P, we can say this point will also move in the rightward direction. And if this distance is r dash, so velocity we can say here should be equal to r dash multiplied by omega, and motion of this point will be also circular about this point, correct? If we consider topmost point, this is the topmost point. Here the radius of rotation of topmost point about point P should be equal to 2r, and angular velocity is omega. So this velocity in tangential direction should be equal to omega multiplied by 2r, that is 2v. That is the double the velocity of center of mass. And we also observe this velocity is 2v by using the superposition method. We can say here again, the velocity of the topmost point is double the velocity of the center of mass of pure rolling object. In similar fashion, if we take one more point here, radius of rotation will be this, and circular path of this point will be like this. So we can make the radius and velocity like this. And similar fashion, we can make the velocity vector of any other point situated on the rigid body. Now we can observe this point. This point is momentarily at rest, and total body is rotating about this point. This point P is called the instantaneous center of rotation of the body. Now let us make one very important point about the pure rolling. As rolling object move, next point of the rim come in contact with the ground, and that point become the instantaneous center of rotation. We can observe here in this diagram, this object is moving in the rightward direction. We can observe the next point on the rim will come in the contact with the ground, and that time the total body, that is the sphere, will rotate about that point.